Good afternoon. At CuteCircuit, we're designing the future of fashion. We use smart textiles and advanced microelectronics to create the fashion of the future. And these fashions are spectacular garments that do many amazing different things. And this is something that we've been doing for quite some time, actually. This is 2014, and CuteCircuit was founded in 2004. So we've been designing wearable technology for 10 years. That's a decade of wearable technology. And as Sunny mentioned in the very first session, he said, you know, when they started 4 years ago, you said wearable technology to somebody, and they were like, what? So imagine 10 years ago, when we said we were starting a wearable technology company, people thought we were insane. Everybody thought we were insane. So it's very happy to see an audience here with everybody interested in wearable technology, because that's a big change. People often ask, you know, has fashionable technology been the concept of CuteCircuit from the very beginning? And the answer actually is yes. The very beginning of the brand, we wanted to create a brand around the concept of fashionable wearable technology to give people new capabilities, new ways to express themselves through fashion. And one of the very first things that Francesca and I designed together, actually, we're going to show a little history of the company, and then we're going to show a little bit of the most recent designs that CuteCircuit has done. You may have heard of this. It's called the Hug Shirt.
The Hug Shirt is the world's first touch telecommunication device. We came up with the Hug Shirt back in 2002, and the version you see here is a version from 2006 that we showed at Wire Next Fest and was awarded by Time Magazine as one of the best inventions of the year. And everybody wanted to have one. We got 3 million people coming to our website and try to buy them, even like Oprah and Ellen, everybody wanted it. And we only had two. So we've been working since to make it possible, and we just showed at New York Fashion Week just 3 weeks ago the new version that everybody can finally have. But what is the Hug Shirt? The Hug Shirt is a t-shirt that lets you hug people over distance. So imagine you're here in London and your best friend is in Tokyo and you want to send her a hug. You put on the Hug Shirt, you give yourself a squeeze, and sensors in the fabric capture where you're touching, how strong, for how long. All this data goes Bluetooth into your smartphone and is transformed into the hug message. And when your friend back in Tokyo receives the message, it says, there is a hug for you, you want to feel it. And your friend, of course, she's wearing the Hug Shirt 24/7, she told me. She's going to say yes, and her shirt is going to get warm and vibrate in the same area that you touched on your shirt. So if you gave yourself a pat on the shoulder, well done, dear. Or if instead you dance a Macarena, then your friend will be able to feel all this touch through you. So it's a new way of communicating. And the thing that was really fun is that we did the user testing with hundreds of people to find the areas on the body of some person that the people touch the most when they hug someone. And we had them hug for hours and hours and hours. And some of them got married at the end. So hugging is very good for you in more than one way. And so this is the new design. And I'll show you a short video.
So the Hug Shirt, that was from the very first one was designed in 2003, too. And then the first prototype you saw, that was 2006, and then the video was just a few weeks ago. But around 2006, when we first showed the Hug Shirt at Wired Next Fest, they invited us back the next year, but they said, we want to see something cool again, something new. And I noticed that Francesca had this problem that whenever I was calling her, she wouldn't answer the phone. And afterwards, I said, why don't you answer when I call? And she said, well, I tried to, but it was at the bottom of my purse and I couldn't reach it. And I thought, that's silly. Why do you need a mobile phone at the bottom of your purse if you can't answer it? So we designed the M-dress. The M-dress is a dress that becomes your mobile phone. So you take the SIM card out of your existing phone and you put it in the tag of your dress, and your dress gets the phone number of your existing phone. And so then when people call you, the dress rings. And you answer the phone by raising your wrist, and there's an accelerometer in the wrist that opens the connection, and you talk to the microphone and the speaker in the wrist, and then when you drop it, it closes the connection. So this was shown at Wired Next Fest, and I think it's the world's first wearable mobile phone, actually. And about that time, when we were working with Wired on these two shows, some people from the Museum of Science and Industry in Chicago came to us and they said, you know, we're making a gallery for the 75th anniversary of our museum. And this gallery is going to be about the future of everything. So we're going to have the future of healthcare and the future of food production and the future of transportation. And we'd like you guys to come up with a new concept for the future of fashion. And so we proposed a few things to them, but one that really stuck out was this idea of the galaxy dress. We wanted to create a dress that had a living surface that could display anything across the surface of the dress.
Dress is embroidered by hand with 24,000 micro LEDs. It took us 6 months to do it. And at a certain point, the exhibition was supposed to open the 4th of October, and we were still there embroidering. And at a certain point, we got this really awesome curator from the museum. She came to embroider with us because she really likes to do arts and crafts. And so we managed to get it done. And this video, we actually took at 2 in the morning while the cleaning crew was cleaning just right before the opening at 9 a.m. the day after. So it was like really a tour de force to get it done. But this was like our dream, to have a fabric that would just like react to the environment or the people around it and just keep changing like a chameleon. And many people say, okay, but I saw the galaxy dress in the museum, has been there since 2008, and millions of people see it every year and it's always on. They're like, but it's plugged into the wall, of course, because I mean, it's in the museum, so they cannot just unplug it and plug it every day. So like, you cannot walk around with it. So we decided to disprove this, and actually you can walk around, and we have a little video here to prove it. And this one is a version called the Aurora dress that you can also see on our website. And it's just, it keeps changing color and it just looks really beautiful. And when we designed this dress, someone saw it in the museum. And she's like, oh, I really want to go to the Met Gala wearing it. And the museum were like, no way. It took us months to get it. We're not going to send it out. Not right now. So we designed a new dress for this lovely lady here. And this is what she had to say about it.
Thank you. This is a company called CuteCircuit. They're from France. And I like, you know, things that light up. I love living in the future. I feel like when Blade Runner predicted the future, I'm living in it now, you know?
Okay, so we call Katie the patron saint of wearable technology. Because until Katie spoke up back in 2010 on the red carpet at the Met Gala, people were all like, wearable technology, this is not fashion. And instead, as soon as Katie said, yes, I love this, like, hundreds of people say, yes, we want to have wearable technology too. And we designed this little dress that, of course, is called the K dress in honor of Katie. And it's made like with the same silk and the same lighting. It just has a little bit less lights because we wanted to have a more affordable price range. But the thing that I really like about this dress is that basically it sort of merges seamlessly our advanced lighting technology that is very tiny and like USB rechargeable with something like pleated silk that has been done by one of the last two remaining pleaters in London, that is an old gentleman that uses his grandfather cardboard molds to pleat all the silk by hand. And it's a lengthy process. You pleat all the silk between two layers of cardboard, and then you put it in an autoclave, and with the steam, it becomes pressed in the shape. So I really like the idea that we're using some traditional crafts, and then we're bringing it together with advanced technology so that we can preserve both the history of fashion and the future of fashion. Ooh. Okay, this one is another thing that we did with Katie, and we really wanted to push the boundaries here, and we're like, we're not going to make you a dress, we're going to make something that stretches, because we really were curious to see if we could do stretchable circuits that would survive Katie's dancing. And this is the result. This is Katie performing E.T. on American Idol.
Friends.
So we know all Katie's songs by heart, of course. Because basically when we do this kind of thing for her performances, we have to listen to her song hundreds and hundreds of times until we get all the timings right. And then we can pre-program the rights in our cue software that goes with the click track. So the musicians start their click track for the music and automatically the garments start on the same click track and have all the timings perfectly exact to everything she needs to have on stage. I'm going to give this back to Ryan because this is like menswear, so he wants to say it.
About this time, as you can see, a lot of the technologies we develop, they're very compatible with performers and celebrities that want to make a statement. And we had these guys, you two, come to us, and they said, normally Bono gets the goodies, he gets to dress fancy, but this time we want the whole band to look really cool. And so we came up with this concept of making video jackets for all four of the guys. But one of the unusual things about this is that they have, as you probably know, U2 does these absolutely spectacular stage shows. They're incredible. And so as a result, their lighting crew wanted them to be able to control all four jackets in real time in order to match it to the light performance of the show. So we developed a special desktop software that would allow that to happen. And so this is a quick video from the opening night. So when we made these jackets, actually, we brought them to the Denver, what's it called, the Denver Stadium, and we put them up so that the guys could see them. And we had talked with their stylist, and she said, all the guys pretty much wear jackets, but Larry, the drummer, because he drums, he's swinging his arms around, he's sweating all the time, the only thing he'll wear is T-shirts, so could you make him a T-shirt? We're like, well, okay, T-shirt's a much lighter material, it's a stretch material. It's gonna be difficult, but we'll try. And so we sort of very meticulously worked on this T-shirt so that it looked absolutely perfect. And it took about twice as much time as any of the other jackets. And we had them on display for the band to see, and everybody came back and they're like, oh, these jackets are awesome. Bono was like, it's incredible. And Larry looked at the three jackets and he looked at his T-shirt and he looked at the jackets and he looked at his T-shirt and he's like, but I want a cool jacket like that. So, at 2 a.m, underneath the Denver Stadium, we worked all night long to develop him his own special jacket overnight.
Basically, sometimes they call us the Miracle Squad because some artist comes to us and say, I have my tour starts tomorrow. And we're like, sure. So, sometimes we managed to do it and we were lucky that we had developed everything. And then we just basically cut the pattern for a new jacket, started sewing it, and it was like freezing cold, but we managed. But we took our revenge in the T-shirt department when we did these just 2 years ago.
So after we had developed the T-shirt for him, we thought, well, what about a really basic garment like a T-shirt? Could we make a T-shirt that just does absolutely everything? So we call this the Kitchen Sink Project because the concept from the beginning was to see how much we could put into a single garment. So we developed this. It's called T-shirt OS. And it is a T-shirt that connects to the internet, it connects to Facebook, it can show your Facebook feed, it connects to Twitter, it shows Twitter feeds, it can take photographs, it can display photographs, it can play music, it can display, it can do everything. And so here's a quick video to show some guys.
First of all, hello.
suppose you're here to see the,
and we're here to show you
show
the,
you.
Okay then, may we present to you T-shirt OS!
Outfit of the future.
Have you been wearing it?
Yes, of course we've been wearing it.
This thing's unbelievable. It's alive! It's alive!
It just seemed like such a stupid thing to do, to have it locked up. You know, just locked away. Shall we?
No. We are not taking it out.
Okay, look at me. We're taking this out tonight. So we thought it was our job to see if we could
Get some girls.
Connects with our demographic.
I've given him strict instructions. Don't overload the circuitry.
Don't get it wet. Don't feed it after midnight. Get it, Ollie. The initial reactions to our little gizmo here were encouraging.
That's when I saw the most beautiful girl.
Target audience.
I couldn't wait to show her the 1024 LED screen really in full action.
Hey, look, it's you!
That's hot.
She gave us an address. It would have been rude not to go. It was a party. It was kind of an art thing. Not really my kind of thing, art.
So I decided to help.
Force.
Encourage Ollie to get hooked up himself.
If you want to see how it ends, we call it the Hangover Part 4. You can see it on our website at t-shirt-os.com. Yeah, Arayan is wearing one. Wow. What you got? Oh, dots. Okay. Oh, he has an even better one. You got the tiger. Yes. This one is a National Geographic video. We got like a few seconds of it and then just formatted it to go to the t-shirt. So basically you can create your own media and put it on the t-shirt and just go out and have fun with your friends. So then afterwards you can see it close up at the party, cocktails, drinks later tonight.
Awesome. One cool thing about the t-shirt, it actually is playing video at 25 frames a second, which is standard video format. So it means that if you get a video that's off of a YouTube or something, and you put it through the converter, you can have that same video at the same frame rate played on your shirt. So, shortly after this, we had developed this concept of having social media connected clothing. The hug shirt was actually their first internet connected clothing, but with the social media, people were getting really excited about this idea, and we decided we'd like to make a couture Twitter dress. And so that is what you see here. This is the Twitter dress. And you may have heard of the Twitter dress because it was first worn by Nicole Scherzinger at the Battersea Power Station for the grand opening of the EE mobile network. And she wore it there, and the cool thing was that they had promoted the hashtag in advance so that as she was coming down the red carpet to this event, her fans could send tweets to the dress and they would show up in real time across the surface of her dress. And again, one of Francesca's Miracle Squad stories, she said, well, you know, I'm wearing this really lovely dress to the red carpet part, but I'm going to perform afterwards. I can't just wear a normal dress. You guys have to make me another dress. So actually, we made two dresses for Nicole that night, and you'll see both of these in the quick video.
I'm wearing the first couture Twitter dress by CuteCircuit, and it's crazy!
Nicole Scherzinger making Twitter fashion history after wearing a crystal-encrusted digital dress which lights up to spell out tweets sent by fans.
It's a dress that they designed specifically for me, and I have all these LED packs and lights hidden on my body, and then all these gorgeous lights are coming down.
The singer unveiled the creation at the star-studded launch of 4G at Battersea Power Station. So sick, can
I put the stick through the thing? I don't think that I can stop.
No, I'll never stop.
And Scherzy wasn't the only one lit up. The venue also hosted an impressive light show to celebrate the launch of the new network.
So I know the question that's burning in your mind is, what did the fashion police have to say about this?
I absolutely love this dress, regardless of the fact that it has live tweets on it. It's one of the best dresses I've ever seen her wear. It's cut nice on her, it's not showing too much skin, but it is showing skin in the right places. Her hair and her makeup looks beautiful. It's amazing, and I think it's a start of a new trend. I am absolutely obsessed with this. Yeah.
So after seeing all these like tweeting dresses, we were approached by Magnum, the ice cream brand, because they wanted to be, they wanted us to be their brand ambassadors for the launch of haute couture ice cream flavors in pink and black. And they're like, okay, we really like the idea of tweet, but can we make it even more interactive? And so we came up with this idea that we would make people vote via Twitter saying, I love this dress in pink, or I love this dress in black. And a celebrity wearing the garments on the red carpet in different markets all over the world would sort of just walk on the red carpet, and every 20 seconds, their dress would change color. Yeah, okay, yeah. So we'll show you like a quick video, but the thing that is amazing is that Turkey has the largest ice cream budget in the world. And so they got the whole country to vote, and when finally they voted for pink, the whole city of Istanbul turned pink. It looked amazing. And in all that, Ryan was in the middle of the Bosphorus on a boat with the model live on CNN. I'd like to invite Guldan, our wonderful product development director, to please come on stage, because she's wearing something really special, that is the Galaxy mini skirt and the Twirkle shirt. And basically, the Twirkle shirt that also you see up here, yeah, reacts to Guldan's movement. So she was walking while she came up the stairs, and her shirt was reacting to your movement. So the more she moves, the more it lights up and changes color. And we developed this t-shirt when we launched our website for an online store 4 years ago. We really wanted to have something that everybody could have that had the same LED technology that we have in all the awesome pop star garments, but something that could be for everyday life, worn by everybody. And we did 2 years of wash tests for this t-shirt, and finally we made something that can be washed in the washing machine, 30 degrees, with our usual soap and conditioner and softener. And then you just hang it to dry, and charges USB very quickly, just a couple of hours, and then you can dance the night away. It has like acceleration sensors, so it knows if you're wearing it or if you're taking it off and just putting it back into your closet, and it just saves the power until the next time you want to use it. And instead, the mini skirt and the jacket, they're like from our latest ready-to-wear collection, and the mini skirt is a Bluetooth low-energy mini skirt that is connected to your iPhone and is running the Cube by CuteCircuit iPhone app. So the skirt is tweeting. If you guys want, you can tweet and then see all your tweets coming up on Guldan's mini skirt. We decided to sort of merge all the things that we like the most about our collections. And oh, the hashtag, yes, just tweet at CuteCircuit, and all your tweets are going to be in here. And she just can change color, so it's really, really fun. And she has the tiger too, because of course, somebody else that really likes tigers wanted to wear this skirt for her concert. So we show you like a very, very quick clip for it. And yeah, tweet at CuteCircuit, and let's see this. And so Guldan can leave us. You'll see her later. She's going to hang out here so you can keep tweeting, and then they're going to appear. And I'll show you a quick video.
iTunes! You're ready to roll!
know the song anyway. So, okay, we're going to skip. You want to skip this? Okay, we'll show you a few seconds of this because it's another menswear thing.
You may have seen this. It's in the cinemas and it's on television now. It was launched about 3 months ago. It's the new Mercedes ad called Sound with Power. But you'll see the jacket in there is showing his emotions. And we developed that jacket, actually, as well. And this is the first time that it was used, was in this ad.
We bring the stars out.
Okay, so now to conclude our presentation, we'd like to show you a brief clip of the finale of our catwalk show. We just showed on schedule at Mercedes-Benz Fashion Week in New York City, and this is the finale.
And I think at CuteCircuit, the thing that we're really trying to do is that we're trying to think out of the box, both literally and figuratively. We're like really trying to make everything that you see in boxes now, like mobile phones, cameras, trackers, everything that is in a box is going to disappear and become textiles, because textiles are becoming smarter and smarter. Microelectronics is becoming slower, like tinier and tinier. So if everything can be embedded on our bodies, then our bodies will become the interface. Our garments are going to be our second skin that allows us to communicate with other people and places. So here you see our finale, and I'd like to invite our PR director, Carmen, here to demonstrate the beautiful dress that she's wearing. And we're going to do a little bit of a reenactment of the fashion show. Yeah, come here in the center, camera. And so we'll get the music started. And we'd like to say thank you to our friends at Intel for giving this Intel Power tablet that we used to shoot a documentary that Intel just published with us. And so we're going to use this tablet to control Carmen's dress. And she's going to look awesome. Baby, I sing the body electric. Thank you very much for seeing our presentation today. If you have any questions, ask us later. Thank you again.